Sometimes it takes me a little while to catch on. Happy Fours Day. Now, it's taken me a few weeks to process this, and I can perhaps attribute it to the rune I have, maybe. And it's got a lot to do with personal gnosis, my personal experiences, and what it leads into. So, to set the scene, I want to go back a couple of weeks to the Althing in Northallerton. Run by Asatru UK, and on one of the nights, my friend Jules, she ran Hell's Blot, ran led Hell's Blot. Now, I, to be honest, wasn't that fussed about taking part in it. I was still, as much as anything, uncertain how I felt or feel about hell. But nonetheless, I decided to take part in Hell's Blot. And it was a very good experience. I'm very glad that I did take part. It was led brilliantly. It opened really well, centered around the campfire, which there are some fantastic photos from. Just to refresh my memory a little bit, I mean, it started with Stephen doing some drumming and singing, which really set the tone brilliantly. It was really good. And I engaged with the moment. Now, when Jules started leading the ritual, it was the first ritual with Asatru UK I've done where it's connected in a way that I would personally choose to sort of draw people in. And that it was very much a meditation, grounding us, sort of focusing our power to the block, to the fire. And it was powerful. I mean, that would be my underlying word, especially once it was over and everyone, a lot of people felt the power. It was a truly sort of powerful moment. To repeat myself, I apologize for repeating myself. So for many people, it was quite personal. I'm not going to name names, that there were things going on, or people have had things happen, that there was a chance to write letters or notes that were put into the fire to sort of be taken to loved ones. I didn't write anything, or I had no agenda. I was there to be there and to take part. So for me, my experiences were sort of once I'd entered into the meditation, seeing some runes, in particular The second rune I saw led me to connect to Balder. Now, this is where the realization, or the thing that sort of settled in for me, settles a debate I was undecided on, and is a debate that surfaces frequently in social platforms about Norse paganism. And this is the debate about whether Ragnarok has happened or not. And until today, I was still very much, I don't know. I think there's arguments for and arguments against. However, I say processing what I experienced in Hell's Blot. I made connection to Balder, who reached to me from Hell's Blot, from Helheim, with the phrase that I've heard from him on previous moments, that better days will return. And it is only today that I've come to the conclusion, really, to settle this, has Ragnarok happened or not? Well, it hasn't. Balder is still in Helheim. So the things that we have as our sources, I can accept. Yes, Loki has been orchestrated, or has orchestrated, the death of Balder. Balder is in Helheim. Petitions to get Balder from Helheim have not worked. And obviously, in Völuspá, we are told that once Ragnarok has finished, Balder will return. Obviously, there is some scholarly debates about that, whether that's Christian influence or not. That I don't have an answer for. It is just, this is how Völuspá is recorded, written, translated, that even when there is this twilight of the gods, that afterwards things return, and some of the gods, as far as we know, return, and that Balder returns to take the place of Odin. So obviously this is a personal experience, and I can't say people have to accept that what I'm saying is sort of the way it is. It is just, I guess, really, sort of through this powerful Hell's Blot, going in there with no motive or no agenda, what I was given has given me an answer that it's taken me sort of 3 weeks to sort of come to the realization that there is an answer there, that something was given to me. It's just slow on the uptake to realize what it was. There's been a lot going on. I mean, I'm not going to make excuses. It's obviously also questioning yourself. Again, it's that sort of, is this the answer I wanted? Is my subconscious working against me? I don't think so. I think what other people think, that is their business, your business. But that's my genuine sort of feeling and conclusion from a very powerful experience that was led, contributed, and concluded brilliantly by everyone that was involved, with the Hell's Block. So yeah, that story, that process, and my conclusion, I'm saying it is my conclusion, is that Ragnarok has not yet happened. How far away it is, I wouldn't like to say. I guess that's another debate. Something to sort of be on the lookout for. Anyway, thank you very much if you've watched this. I hope you've appreciated it and liked it. And if you do like it, press the like button or subscribe, comment. You are most welcome to challenge my experience. I welcome it. I want to question. I do question myself and my experiences, and I'm happy for other people too. I will always accept that people will not conclude things the same way, or will conclude differently, have different experiences, or even think that my experiences put me on the edge of sanity. That's the world we live in. I know what's in here, and again, that's one of the things I've found of late in conversation. We've been repeating that it's the gods know what's in there. So yeah, cheers, goodbye.